Hello guys, welcome back to another Android Studio tutorial. In this episode, we are going to create an Android application that demonstrates how to working with Android runtime permissions. So here I'm going to create the same Android application that I already explained in the previous video. So open Android Studio and start a new Android Studio project. Here I name the project as runtime permission test. Select empty activity, click finish. Okay, now here the project is created. First we can set up the user interface of the application. Here I create the user interface of the application. So this application need three permissions: camera, external storage, and read contacts. Here is the XML file. This is the button for using camera with onclick method open camera. This is the button for write to external storage with onclick method write to storage. And here is the final button for read contacts with onclick method read contacts. Now here I'm going to implement all these three methods inside main activity. So implement the first method. Now implement second method. Now implement the last method. So here all the onclick methods are implemented inside main activity. So to distinguish these methods, put some decorations here, put some comments here. So these are the onclick methods of the buttons. Okay, to display the result, here I need another activity. So create a new activity. Select activity. Select an empty activity. Specify activity name. Here I name it as a result activity and click finish. Now the newly created activity is created. Now go to the layout file. Here I'm going to add a text view. So here I add a text view to the result activity layout file. Here is the XML, here is the text view with ID text view. So it will display the permission details. Now go to the result activity.java. So we can initialize that text view. I name it as text view. Now initialize that one. It is a text view. Now find it. Okay. Now here check some conditions. If get indent dot get text class not equal to null, in that case we have to get the string from the indent extra. So create a variable called message get indent dot get text class get string. Specify the key for the string. Here it is message. Okay, and finally we are going to display this message on the text view. Okay, that is the code segments associated with the result activity. So now we can close the result activity and its layout file. So for this application we need three permissions. We need to use camera, external storage, and we need to read the contacts. So we have to register, we have to specify these permissions inside manifest file. So open manifest folder, open android manifest.xml. Here you need to specify the needed permissions. These are the three permissions needed for this application. Here is the permission for using camera. Here is the permission for using write external storage. here is the permissions for using for read contacts. So all these three are dangerous permissions. So if there is dangerous permission in your Android application, you need to get permission from user at the runtime. Now go to main activity.java. So first here we need to declare some variables. Here I declare some needed variables. Here these are all integer value, final static, request camera, request storage, request contacts. So these are the integer value we need at the time of request a permission. And here I declare another integer value, TXT camera. So these are the variables we need to identify which are the permissions we actually call. Okay, so now when we request a permission, we have to check whether the permission is appear for the first time or not. That means the user request the permission for first time or not. So when user request a permission for the first time, we have to save a flag on the shared preferences. So we have to check if the permission is asked for the second time, we have to display an explanation for the permission. So we have to identify whether this permission is requested before or not. So when a permission is requested for the first time, we are going to add a flag to the shared preference with the corresponding permission name. So now here I'm going to create a separate class for the shared preferences. Before going to do that, we need to add some string values inside strings.xml. So open strings.xml and you need to add some string values. Here I add some string values inside strings.xml, permission preference, permission camera, permission storage, and permission contacts. Now I'm going to create a separate Java class for handle the shared preferences. Create a new Java class. Right click package, it is better. Specify the class name and create it. Here I add all the needed code segments for the class. So first here I declare some variables, context, shared preferences, and shared preferences editor. So this is a constructor of this class with one parameter is a context, and we initialize the context variable from the constructor. We initialize shared preferences by using this method get shared preferences and get the preference file name from the strings.xml by using this method get string, and here we open it in mode private. And here is the editor for shared preference. We initialize both shared preferences and editor from the constructor of this class. Okay, here we have a method called update permission preference. So if the user requests a permission for the first time, if the permission request appear for the first time, we have to update that particular permission name with a flag inside the shared preference. So this is the method that perform the shared preference updation. So here this method has a parameter is a string value, that is the permission name. So here we check whether the permission is a camera, storage, or contact using a switch statement. So here in each case we check individual permission, camera, storage, or contacts. So if it is a camera permission, we are going to put a boolean value into the shared preference. We get the permission name. So inside strings.xml we already specify the permission name, permission camera, storage, and contact. So here we get it from the strings.xml and put the value true for that permission. That means that particular permission is already requested before, and we commit the transaction. We commit it. That means save the flag into shared preference. And here the same thing for the second permission storage, again the same thing for the third permission contact. So this is the method that perform update on the shared preference. So now we need another method for checking whether the permission is requested before or not. So this is the method that we are going to use to check whether the permission is already requested or not on the shared preference flag. So here also there is a string parameter. It is the permission name. Here I declare a boolean value is shown. I initialize that one with the value false. So here we check each of the permission name. If it is camera, we get the data from shared preference by this method get boolean. The default value is false, and save that into this variable is shown. If the permission is already requested before, it will return true. So that value, that data is saved into this variable is shown. And finally, return that particular boolean from this method. This method return type is a boolean value. So this is the Java class we used to handle the shared preferences. Now go to mainactivity.java and create some variables for the permission util class. Permission util, I name it as permission util. Now initialize that object from the onCreate method. A new permission util and pass context. Okay, now here I am going to add a method that check whether the permission is already granted or not. So this is the method that check whether the permission is already granted or not. Check permission. Okay, so here the method name is check permission, and that contain one parameter. It is an integer value. So here we check that parameter, that integer value, using a switch case statement. So here we compare that value on each of these case statement: txt camera, txt storage, and txt conduct. So these are integers we already declare here. Okay, so if the permission is camera, here we check the permission using this method check self permission, and this method need two parameter, context and name of the permission. So if the permission is already granted, this method will return permission granted, pyketmanager.permissionGranted. If the permission is not requested before, this method will return pyketmanager permission denied. So here I already declare a variable called status. Here the default value of that variable is pyketmanager.permissionDenied. So if the permission is granted before, we change the value of this variable into permission granted. And we do the same thing for all these variables. And finally, we return that variable from this method. It is an integer value. So here the return type of this method is an integer. So this is the method that we are going to use to check whether that permission is already granted or not. Now here I'm going to add another method for request a new permission. So if the permission is not granted, we have to request a new permission. So here I'm going to add another method for requesting a new permission. So here this is the method for request a new permission. Method name is request permission. Request new permission. Okay, so here the return type of this method is void, and this method has one parameter. It is an integer value, permission. So here we check the integer value using a switch case statement. If it is a camera permission, we have to request for camera permission. So here I use this method request permission, and this method need three parameter. First one is the activity context. Second one is the name of the permission. So here you have to specify the name of the permission in the form of a string array. You can request a group permission also, but here it is only a single permission. So you have to specify the name of the permission inside this string array. And finally, you have to specify a request identifier. It is an integer value. So here a request camera is an integer that here we already declared that one. Here is the request integer for storage. This is for contacts. So this is for identifying that particular permission request. So when we handle the response from the user interaction, we have to use this request permission number. Okay, so you can use any integer value for that one. So this is for camera, and here this is the permission request for storage. This is the permission request for contact. So this method perform a new permission request. So now I'm going to create another method that display an explanation to the user. If the user deny the permission for the first time, when the user requests the same permission, when the application needs the same permission again, before going to display the permission request for the second time, it is better to display an explanation to the user why the app needs that permission. So now here I'm going to create another method that will display an explanation to the user. So this is the method that will display an explanation to the user. Here the method name is show permission explanation. Display permission explanation. Okay. So here the return type of this method is void. Here also there is one parameter, it is an integer that specify what is the permission. So here we are going to display the explanation using an alert dialog. So here I create an object for alert dialog. So here we check if the permission is camera. If the permission is camera, we set title for the alert dialog into camera permission needed, and this is the explanation for the camera permission. We use this method set message. So here if the permission is contact, we set title and message. If it is storage, we set title and message for the explanation. So this is the positive button on the alert dialog. It is allow. If the user want to allow the permission, in that case, in the onclick method, here we have to check if it is camera permission. We call the method request permission. That means we are going to request a permission again. So we call the method request permission and pass the permission number text camera. So if it is storage, we request a permission with integer storage. Otherwise, if it is contact, we request a new contact permission. If the user click the negative button, that means cancel button, we simply dismiss the dialog. And finally, we display the alert dialog. So these are the three important methods needed for the application. This is the first method that check for the permission. The permission is already granted or not. And this is the second method that request a new permission. And finally, this is the method that display an explanation to the user. Okay, now we can handle each of these permission requests. So if the user click the camera, it will open this method. So from this method, we can request a new permission. So here I add all the needed code segments for open camera on click method. So when we needed a new feature for the application that needed dangerous permission, so each time when you open that particular segments, that particular feature, you have to check you have permission for using that features or not. So here I check that one. So here I call the method check permission and pass the permission name, it is camera. And if the permission is denied, that means it is not granted before, in that case it will return permission denied. That means this if loop will return true. That means the permission is not granted before. So in that case, first we have to check whether the permission is requested before. If the permission is already requested before, we have to display an explanation to the user. So you can Check whether the permission is requested before by using this method should show request permission rationale. That method need two parameters. First one is the context. Second one is the permission name. So if the permission is requested before, this method will return true. And if the permission is requested for the first time, or the user click the don't show again message on the dialog, this method will return false. So if the permission is requested before, this method return true. So in that case, we display an explanation to the user. So here we call that method show permission explanation, and we pass the permission name. Otherwise, so here we consider the second case. That means if the permission is requested for the first time, so here we call the method check permission preference from the permission util class. So here we check the clock on the shared preference whether the permission requested for the first time or not. If the permission is requested for the first time, we simply call this method request permission and pass the permission name. At the same time, we have to update the flag on the shared preference. So we call the method update permission preference. Otherwise, that means if the user select the option don't ask it again on the permission request dialog, in that case we handle that situation here. In that case, we have to lead the user to the application settings. User can enable the permission from the application settings. So here we display a toast message, please allow camera permission in your app settings. So here we create some indent object. We specify some action for the indent. Here the action is action application detail settings. Specify some URI, get the package name, and finally set the data on the URI and start the activity. So here we open the application settings page so that the user can enable the permission from the application settings. So if the permission is already granted before, in that case this else part is executed. In that case, we display you already have camera permission, and we start the result activity. So here we create indent for the result activity, and we add some message to the indent by using this function put extra with the key message. And this is the message: you can now take photos and record videos in the case of a camera app. And finally, we start the activity. Now we have to do the same thing for these other two permissions, write to storage, and finally read the contacts. So here I add the same code segments for the storage and contact. So here I know this is a serious spelling mistake, sorry for that. So now we finish the code is code segments for the Android runtime permission request. So now we can test our application. Now I'm going to run this application, select a virtual device. Now here the application available on this virtual device. First I am going to use camera. So I have to allow camera permission. So this is a standard system dialog. So here I allow the permission. So now I need to write something into the external storage. So I need the storage permission. So first here I am going to deny that permission. So that permission is denied. So I try to use the same feature again. So in that case, that particular permission is rejected before. So we have to display an information to the user why this permission is important for this application. So here I click allow and allow that application. So here we didn't put the code segments for handle the click events of the permission request dialog. We can I will explain in the next video. So here in this application, now we already grant permission for using camera and for using external storage permission. So now I'm going to read contact. So now deny that permission. Now try to read contact again. Now this time it will show an explanation. Now I'm going to deny that permission again by select this option, don't ask it again, and deny that one. So in this situation, if I try to read contact again, it will lead the user to the application settings page. So from permission, user have to enable permission for read contact. So here I enable permission for contact and I revoke the camera permission. User can revoke any permission at any time. Now go back to the application again. Now I have contact permission, external storage permission, but the camera permission is I already removed from the permission settings. So now it will display an information to the user. This application needs camera, so I allow it, allow that permission again. So now the user can use camera. So this is how we request a single permission at the runtime on Android version 6.0 and above. I hope you understand all the concepts. Please subscribe this channel for getting more Android tutorial updates. Thank you for watching. See you in the next episode.